What's going on?
I'm shy.
We gotta do this.
I can't.
Yes, you can.
Okay. Oh, this? You'll find out. Here, let me clarify. Good morning. My name is Elizabeth Thipp. Nice to meet you. And thank you all for being here for my senior talk. Raise your hand if you can speak more than one language. Now, look around. Did you know that most people are bilingual in this school? They say that being bilingual helps when you are switching your attention, depends who you are with. There are many benefits of being bilingual, such as getting hired, earning higher salaries, and getting a promotion. I am going to tell you a story. It all started on a bus on Christmas Eve. My friend Noah and I arrived to the bus. We noticed this elderly person whom we let go in first, but he denied to let him go in first. No, to let us go in first. So once we sat down, Noah told me he was deaf. My response was, "What? Really?" We looked back. He was all the way in the back of the bus. He was signing to this random person. He had his earphones on. He thought he was crazy. He kept nodding, yeah, and yeah. It took us a moment to move in front of him. We introduced ourselves to him. We could not capture his name, but he was really friendly that we knew American Sign Language, or ASL. Through communication, he was into video games, but he wasn't a big fan of smartphones. He had two family members with him. They were both married, and he was single since he was young. We talked for at least 30 minutes, and knowing that we made an attempt to communicate with him made him happy, and it made our Christmas Eve. This experience motivates me to show people that ASL is another language, and it can change people's lives. One way I want to impact the world by not only telling others through my story, the other is how ASL can be a way to help people get out of their comfort zone and to express themselves in another way. I was never the person to speak on stage. I was a shy girl that rarely raised her hand and did not participate in any group conversations. And it took years for me to step out of my comfort zone. That shy girl was no more when I met Ms. Groff. In her class, my confidence was finally ignited.
Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Concealed don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. Cold never bothered me anyway.
As simple as you might think. My first time signing was nerve-wracking. I became aware of what others were going through because when we sign, the class scrutinized one another. I became more aware and I became a mentor to those who was as shy as I was. Exposure to scrutiny helps when you are on stage. You see, when you are signing, you are pretty much on stage and people are scrutinizing you. You become self-conscious of how you're signing, you're making letters, and your body movements. When you are on stage, the only person that knows what you are signing is you. So if you make a mistake, don't stop, continue, because the audience is unaware of what your presentation will be about. The way is to overcome it is by placing students in groups of 4 to 5 and to provide them with a safe, secure, and scrutiny-free environment. Presenting to a large audience is extremely difficult after being comfortable within a small group. Placing students in groups will help them focus on skills such as public speaking and participation. Did you know that 48% of people are shy? Some people are publicly shy, while others have a hard time advocating for themselves. For example, asking their professor for help or helping others that need it. My goal was to create a group where ASL will be the foundation for getting out of one's comfort zone. I accomplished my goal by creating a group where students will be interested in learning ASL. I work with middle schoolers. At first, there was 20 students that were interested, but in the end, there were 7 passionate students that I am so proud of. I see so much potential in them. Wait and see. The environment that we have created around the area is filled with joy and students becoming comfortable and becoming leaders. Here's a video. What their goals were for that week. Their response were to be less shy, to understand ASL more, and to learn how to communicate in ASL. Out of 7 students, there are 2 students that are shy. I asked them, on a scale of 1 to 10, what their shyness would be. Their response were a 7.1. When I asked who would be interested in presenting in my senior talk, these 2 volunteered. They are challenging themselves, and I know they will become leaders of this in a very near future. I wanted to find out on how each student got out of their comfort zone and how they became confident in themselves. So I emailed the rest of the students, has ASL impacted you in any way? How did this help you get out of your comfort zone? Here's a video.
Help you get out of your comfort zone.
Because I really don't talk a lot and I don't express myself a lot. So doing ASL, I started to express myself a lot more and I started to talk a lot more.
This helped me to get out of my comfort zone because I'm an ESL student. English is my second language. And I don't talk a lot and I don't really like to talk during class, and sometimes when I have questions, I don't even ask because I'm shy. But when I started learning ESL, I learned to get out of my comfort zone and be myself.
It has helped me, mostly because I'm a shy person and I don't like speaking to people outside of school nor during school. And now I would say I'm more outgoing towards school and like making new friends.
Has ASL impacted you in any way?
It has. It's made me speak to new people instead of just speaking like to people that just talk English or Spanish.
It's helped me get out of my comfort zone because I don't like speaking in a huge audience and I'm shy when presenting in front of other people.
Has ASL impacted you in any way?
This has helped me. Now I can talk to other people without being that scared. And I can make more conversations with other people.
How does this help you get out of your comfort zone?
It helped me get out of my comfort zone because it's a new language and I already know too. It's with your hands and not with your mouth.
ASL has impacted me tremendously. I was never the person to speak in class. ASL has helped me gain my confidence so I can step out of my comfort zone. From what I recall, I was good with signing from the beginning, but I was nervous that people would judge me, and I did not feel confident. The song, Let It Go, made me a different person. When I first chose this song, I thought it wasn't right. The lyrics, don't let them in, don't let them see, made me feel that I can do anything. It means to me, don't let negativity ruin your happiness, to be yourself and to love yourself the way you are. Presenting to a large audience showed me that I have a voice. It made me understand that my voice will be heard. It has showed me the confidence of public speaking, participation, and enthusiasm. I am able to express my own feelings and being able to stand up for myself and to motivate other people. I want to pass this down to my group. Come, my little snowflakes.
Easy way, I kept on falling short of something. it in, but don't look down.
I'm on top of the world.
Individual to make a difference. As an audience, what differences do you think you would make? I believe that helping students at a younger age will help them gain confidence. They will be prepared for the rigors of their classes and their senior talks. Ladies and gentlemen, there will be a sign-up sheet with 7 middle schoolers in the audience. We will be meeting in room 58 from Tuesday from 3:30 to 4:30. I am proud knowing that Magdalena and Shania are willing to take over and spreading the news that there is an ASL learning group at this amazing school. Take action and help yourself and others step out of your comfort zone. Thank you. This concludes my senior talk.